Good afternoon, I'm Carmina Constantino bringing you this ANC live event. President Noynoy Aquino is leading the turnover rites at the Philippine Navy. Vice Admiral Jose Luis Alano is replacing Vice Admiral Alexander Pama. Let's go live to the Philippine Navy headquarters.
Philippine Navy. I am in familiar waters. It was not long ago that I relinquished command of the Philippine fleet, one of the sharp ends of a two-bladed sword that makes the Philippine Navy the fleet marine team. As I'm now having a rewarding opportunity of serving the Filipino up close and personal as the commander of Central Command, your AP in the Visayas, where I am constantly awed by how our sailors, soldiers, and airmen face the perils and difficulties of operating in an archipelagic environment of islands scattered in a vast sea space made more challenging with rugged mountain terrains, rendering unwavering devotion in defending our country and protecting our people. What makes this doubly gratifying is that my father and the father of the Commander of Naval Forces Central, Commodore Helacio Alano, was the flag officer in command of the Philippine Navy in the mid-60s. A man who has dedicated his life to service to this country, a pioneer of the offshore patrol of what the Philippine Navy was known during its humble beginnings, which was made up of patrol torpedo boats of the Q-boat squadron. These fast and little watercrafts saw action in defense of the freedom of the Filipino people during World War II against a larger and superior invading force. Serving aboard the Luzon or Q-boat 111, he was awarded the Silver Star for conspicuous gallantry and action, the third highest military decoration for valor in the face of the enemy. I come from a line of public servants who have instilled in me the values of industry, professionalism, integrity, patrimony, and the pride and belief in the Filipino. After having been exposed to a vital task of bringing peace and stability in the Visayas, in line with the AAP's campaign plan Bayanihan, that through a collective effort of all stakeholders, the peace and order situations in Region 6, 7, and 8 is getting better, where the building of infrastructures are ongoing and public services are being reached out to the remotest of areas. This contributed to the 7.1 GDP growth of the country for the third quarter, where the Visayas is becoming a major destination of tourists and economic investments. I am back home. I am back home to home port among shipmates and friends, where I look forward to rolling up my sleeves with a salty breeze on my face and do what a Navy man does, and that is to man, sail, sustain ships, and that includes Marine Battalion landing teams, naval aircrafts, SEAL teams, and Seabees battalions. Allow me to express my deep gratitude. It is always good to thank for and account for the blessings that one receives in life. First and foremost, let me thank the great navigator for all the things around us, but most of all, for what and who we are. To the command leadership, in particular the presiding officer, for the opportunity to continue render service to our maritime nation. To family, friends, batchmates, mistas, and colleagues, through whose support and assistance has made this voyage to this present destination possible. I wish further to extend my congratulations to Vice Admiral Alexander Pama, who is an insightful naval strategist and competent leader, one who has done a lot for the Philippine Navy and the Department of National Defense. I am indeed fortunate as well as challenged to follow in his wake. As is evident, Vice Admiral Pama has done so much for the Navy, particularly in ensuring the formulation of responsive plans and strategies, the proper implementation of policies, the enhancement of the capabilities of naval and marine units, and the wise and effective use of resources. The shoes that he's leaving behind will be tough to fill. He has, however, skillfully laid down the groundwork for me to build on. This is in accordance with the PN sail plan, where each commander takes his charge of his watch and navigates his vessel through unpredictable waters and stormy weather, and safely sail her to each designated waypoint until we reach our destination of building a strong and capable Navy. Sir, my congratulations to you. And as you finally make your final entry in your captain's log, allow me to express my best wishes as you prepare for a new voyage in your life. At this point, let me take a quote from Sir Francis Bacon. If we are to achieve results never before accomplished, we must expect to employ methods never attempted before. We are in exciting times where the Philippine Navy can make a major contribution to the armed forces of the Philippines in the pursuit of its mission and objectives. It is but up for us to seize this golden opportunity. Since the presiding officer has taken helm as the President of the Republic and our Commander-in-Chief, insurgency is on the downturn, and the strategic situation in the environment requires our Defense Department to be more active in the region in ensuring maritime security in Southeast Asia. By being foremost a responsible partner in keeping our waters safe and secured so that freedom of navigation and international trade may continue to flourish. By maintaining the security stability where the economic gains on which our country is now benefiting is not hampered. And by ensuring that the sovereign rights of our maritime nation are secured and protected. In response to the developing situation, in line further with the higher command's guidance coming from no less than the Commander-in-Chief for good governance and reforms, as well as the stress for the respect of the basic rights of every individual as we perform our duties, the Navy to be relevant and responsive shall in accordance with the defense system of management, continue to review its maritime security strategy of active archipelagic defense in such a way that through an accepted scientific, quantitative, and qualitative process, prioritize the desired force mix so as to clearly address the essential capability gaps. The current naval capabilities are then to be sustained by the Defense Resource Management System, further to ensure that the execution of the DSOM is transparent and treading the straight path. We will continue to pursue the PN sail plan, which has seen breakthrough results with its balanced scorecard cascading down to line units, with our four major units of the Navy being ISO certified. We will focus our efforts around five areas. These are the development of the growth of our people, the revisiting of doctrines and organizational structures, the development and sustainment of mission essential capabilities, and the building and enhancement of relationships with stakeholders and coalitions that are essential to the attainment of our common goals and shared desires in the region where our beloved Philippines is part of. And most important, the strengthening of naval values and honor. The course has been plotted, sea details has been set, and the command to cast off all lines has been given. Our personnel are our most vital resource. However, not properly managed, they become our major concern. What we need are not warm bodies, but able-bodied sailors and Marines who are motivated, disciplined, and professionals. This can be achieved through providing a work environment of equality and fairness, conducive to professional growth and addresses their welfare, an environment that shuns ignorance, idleness, and indifference, an environment that provides a career path with a clear purpose, giving equal opportunity to all based on meritocracy, where credit is given, where credit is due, regardless of gender, color, or creed. By using the bell curve quantitative decision-making system, we'll be further be proactive in our personnel recruitment, where we clearly define the skill sets that are needed for sailors and marines, and go out to accredited technical institutions that will be able to satisfy our need. We will pursue the field of specialization for officers and the naval job classification for enlisted personnel until it is fully institutionalized, adapting changes along the way that will be needed to make it workable. We are professionals. As professionals, we must be experts in our field. I come at an opportune time when we are splitting up the new capabilities like the WECs, frigates, naval helicopters, MPACs, AAVs, as well as individual marine and special warfare combat equipment. We will rationalize current operational assets, review the modernization program, taking a deliberate look at the phase-in and phase-out scheme, removing the excess baggage of old and antiquated ships and equipment. That continues to be heavy burdens on our logistics system, and submit recommendation on the type capabilities that will further make us relevant as a relevant service of the armed forces of the Philippines. One that will be able to truly secure our maritime domain and the resources that form part of it for the Filipino and our future generations. As we review our doctrines and operational plans in our quest to be of better service to the Filipino, we have to clearly address not only the issues of operational needs, but the support and sustainment needs as well. The quadruple S words of system, synergy, synchronization, and sustainment are the bywords in how we intend to approach actions in all our endeavors, where we strengthen our respective organizations, capabilities, and systems as experts in our respected fields and gel into one body, making each part stronger through our collective effort, working in unison with the simple beauty of a synchronized motion, sustaining our operations like an ultra-marathon runner through our deploy, repair, sustain, and train programs. This we will do as we strengthen our units, targeting for the full restoration of their mission capabilities while attaining core competencies of our personnel. We will further partner with local industries that will assist us in sustaining high technical gadgets and new developments in technology, believing in the talent, ingenuity, resourcefulness, and can-do attitude of our Filipino engineers and scientists. Doctrines, operational plans, tactics are important and empowering. However, are merely ideas or words placed in pieces of paper that gather dust in our filing cabinets, if not eaten by termites. They can only put into action if they have doers with answers to issues that provide immediate response through long-term solutions. We will develop our training not only along functional lines, but primarily along the capability aspect, for it is only through our fused capability as a fleet marine force of combined arms, working through a seamless effort of jointness, that we are able to deliver the desired outcome for our decision makers. We will conduct regular review of all policies, strategies, and plans, fleshing it out into specific programs, projects, and activities that can be measured and evaluated with given emphasis to lead measures rather than lag measures. Aligned with our defined national security interests, we will further enhance engagement with our counterparts, particularly those who share common interests, values, and beliefs of peace and stability in the region, of freedom of navigation, of respect of the rights of all nations and of peaceful resolution through the observance of the rule of law and due process. In our desire to be more efficient and effective, we hope to address gaps of human resources through contracting technical people for specific services and projects, applying the latest technologies and the best practices in industry. This will be aligned with the government's tuwid na daan, trust of making the most of limited resources through efficiency, underscoring best value for money, thereby stretching the deliverables. These are the immediate to medium-term thrust that the command has laid out through action plans that address the capability upgrade, the sustainment, the morale and welfare of our units with the underlying objective that the ship and the marine battalions are the center of all of this activity. And the people who man and operate them are duly recognized for their hard work and sacrifice. The horizon up ahead is laden with a lot of challenges, but seen on the other end also offer a lot of opportunities. All it takes is for us sailors and marines, the protector of the Philippine seas and defenders of our maritime nation, is to do our part. In closing, to the officers and crew of the Philippine Navy, there will be only one thing that I will ever ask of you, and that is to do what the Navy demands of you, and that is to ensure the freedom and well-being of the Filipino people, maintain peace and security over our Philippine territory, contribute to the development and progress across the archipelago. Maraming salamat. Mabuhay tayong lahat at maligayang Pasko.
Thank you very much, sir. We now proceed with the second part of this afternoon's activity, the retirement ceremony of Vice Admiral Alexander Patiño Pama, Armed Forces of the Philippines.
The Adjutant General AFP will now read the retirement orders of Admiral Pama.
Republic of the Philippines, Department of National Defense, General Headquarters, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Comandante Emilio Aguinaldo, Quezon City. General Orders No. 850, published on 14 September 2012. Compulsory retirement. Pursuant to Sections 5A and 17 of Presidential Decree No. 1638, as amended, and in consonance with the Presidential Administrative Order No. 150, dated 04 January 1990, Vice Admiral Alexander P. Pama, Officer DAS 7936, Armed Forces of the Philippines, having completed 37 years, 9 months, and 26 days of active military service in the Armed Forces of the Philippines from 01 April 1974 and from 25 February 1979 to 20 December 2012, is compulsorily retired in the rank of Vice Admiral with the retirement pay based on the salary grade of Admiral with 5th longevity pay effective 21 December 2012, by order of the Secretary of National Defense, signed Rolando G. Hunco, Brigadier General, Armed Forces of the Philippines, the Adjutant General.
At this point, we shall have the presentation of the command plaque, plaque of honorable service, and medal frame to our honoree. Once more, the Adjutant General, AFP, will read the citations of the AFP command plaque and the plaque of honorable service, one after the other.
The Chief of Staff, Armed Forces of the Philippines, General De Liosa, will present the plaques to Admiral Pama, starting with the command plaque.
General Headquarters, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Comandante Emilio Aguinaldo, Quezon City. Command plaque is presented to Vice Admiral Alexander P. Pama, Officer DAS 7936, Armed Forces of the Philippines, in grateful acknowledgement of his eminently meritorious and valuable service rendered us, Flag Officer in Command, Philippine Navy, from 04 January 2011 to 19 December 2012, given this 19th day of December in the year of our Lord, 2012, at Naval Station Jose V. Andrada, 2335 Ross Boulevard, Manila. Signed, Jesse D. De Liosa, General, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Chief of Staff.
And now to present the plaque of honorable service.
General Quarters, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Comte de Mino Aguinaldo, Quezon City. Plaque of honorable service is presented to Vice Admiral Alexander P. Pama, Officer DAS 7936, Armed Forces of the Philippines, in recognition of his 37 years, 9 months, and 26 days of faithful and honorable service to the Armed Forces of the Philippines during the period from 01 April 1974 and from 25 February 1979 to 20 December 2012. Given this 19th day of December in the year of our Lord, 2012, at Naval Station Jose V. Andrada, 2335, Ross Boulevard, Manila. Signed, Jesse D. De Liosa, General, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Chief of Staff.
Likewise, the Chief of Staff, Armed Forces of the Philippines, will also present a plaque of appreciation to Mrs. Carmela Leticia Aquino.